Hey passengers, welcome back. We are here at Universal Studios. We're gonna be walking in just in a second, but Joe reminded me about the Berlin Wall piece that's attached close by the Hard Rocks. Let's go see it. Welcome, come on. Feels something, we're flying. So, you noticing just the blue, nothing else there, no writing, no nothing? Well, you know, it was announced this past winter that Blue Man Group was no longer going to be here, and they have officially taken down the markings. So, I never got a chance to go to the Blue Man Group show here at Universal Studios, but I think they're still open in Vegas, so maybe I can get a chance to see them there. The Berlin Wall is right here, right in the backside of the Hard Rock Cafe, attached to room 315. I remember you could buy pieces of the Berlin Wall at JCPenney and such back in the day. So let's take a look at it a little closer. All right, so we're walking down. We just got to see the Berlin Wall. And if you were to come this way, gotta turn around, see the rock shops here, go down that path, and that's where the Berlin Wall is. I got to touch a piece of history that would happen during my lifetime. It's kind of cool because I remember the symbolic words that Ronald Reagan used to tear down this wall, or that wall, whichever the quote is. We are inside Universal Studios. Being inside of Hollywood Studios, this is the first time in 2 months I've been able to come back here. I feel like it's been about 2 months. The date of this recording is May the 5th, or Revenge of the 5th. It's hot, folks. I'm telling you what, it's hot. I got my cologne on, and the cologne is basically sunscreen, because it's desperately, definitely needed today. Woo! All right, so Joe's out here. He's putting his sunscreen on right now. Make sure he's all covered. Sun cancer is no joke, folks. So, all right, let's go back on the lighter side. Let's have some fun today. You know, we're walking, I'm gonna get a beverage, and we just realized we don't have any plans. We're just winging every part of today, and we discussed, we like it like that. One thing, the area I'm walking through right now, they had the vehicle for Mardi Gras. That's where some of the jazz musicians would play. And obviously Mardi Gras is well over, but Universal Studios, they kept it alive for a really long time, and it just recently ended. So one thing I'm noticing is there are lines, long lines to some of the places to get a beverage. So it's hot out there. People want to have a beverage as well. You gotta stand in line. All right, so we're here at the Irish Imports little store here inside of Hollywood Studios. Across the way is Finnegan's Bar and Grill. But what caught our attention was this shirt. Read that. See if I can get a better one. All right. I love gingers. Well. Good stuff. I wish I had just a regular t-shirt that I could fit into.
You could do it.
Oh, these are really small looking though. They got an extra large. Uh-oh. I don't like the size of those. They're not big enough. Kinda cool. That's nice. Look at these ducks. Joe got a couple of these for us. And they have one with a beard, but they don't have it here right now. I love rubber duckies.
You know, if you collect the ducks, we have them also in the Christmas. Oh,
they put in the Christmas store.
Really?
Yep. Yeah, so we have the ones that look like reindeers.
Yeah.
And one that looks like we have the Christmas lights.
Oh, I love the ducks.
So that if you go to the Finnegan's and go down to the other corner, that's where you're going to hit the Christmas store.
Awesome. Thank you.
Absolutely.
That's excellent information.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
We appreciate that. Awesome. Cheers. All right. Did you hear that, y'all?
Seems like it's more.
I like the rubber ducks. And you know what I like doing? I went on a cruise and I took some rubber ducks with me and I just set them around, you know, around the cruise area just to see if people want to, because it brings a little happiness and a little cheer. And it brought, it did. People found out it was me and actually they thanked me. So that's really cool. Look at this, Dublin Fire Brigade. I love Dublin, Ireland. It's one of my favorite places to go. I got a really good friend who lives there. So, really good friend Leon, huh? Thinking of you. Look at all those magnets. You know, I don't want to say that I want to buy anything right now, but I'd rather get it in Ireland itself. Ireland. Anyway, kind of cool. Some. Okay, then this is pretty cool. Look, you can get your Christmas decorations. Some more of the Christmas bauble. Guinness, okay. Oh, I know exactly who to get that for. Chris, this is coming for you. I'm not getting it today. Remind me, I'll get another day though, okay? Alright.
My name is Larry.
There you go. Larry.
There it is. The bird. Alright, folks. Well, I've also stayed in here because it's nice and cool. But it's time to hit that heat up. It is hot. I got myself a beverage and getting back into the heat. Fun. We are in line to collect our pass holder button. Hopefully there's also a magnet, but I don't think this month there's gonna be one. But we'll see. This is some of the things you can get. A character candy bar, 3 for $10. And they still always have the Universal Merchandise shopping card, and you get a free wand. Okay, so the wand is about $49 value, you see. Wow, $250? Mm-mm. Okay, I'll buy just a wand. But you can get Jaws, E.T., back. Look at some of these.
It's a raptor egg hatchet.
Oh my gosh.
I think. And
look at that. You see that, folks? That's the pin. And say it again.
I think it's a baby raptor hatching from an egg.
Oh my gosh, it has to be that.
Because it's celebrating the Velocicoaster opening.
Yeah. Oh, it's a girl. Look. My camera's not focusing properly. I think it's getting it. All right. Awesome. All right. So we got ours. Awesome. Let me get mine. Here's some more of the candy bars, and looks like they also have some other gummies. But this is the pass holder lounge. You can come in and relax. It's cool in here, you know, but purchase some masks if you would like, some lanyards and a couple t-shirts and such. Now, one of them that's standing out to me is this. So, I'm not a big rainbow fan, but I do like the Love is Universal that's going on right now with Universal. They're doing this, and I really like this, but my Hufflepuff is my favorite. But I do need a new pouch. Mine is broken, so I need a new one of these. So that's awesome. And I don't know how much these lanyards are, but kind of cool. Well, I couldn't help it. I had to buy it. You know, either I'm going to use it or I'll give it to a friend, but I really do like it. I like the Love is Universal. It's really cool. Some balls, you know. But they also have some face masks. For $1.99, you can get the Universal Mardi Gras face mask. So we got two of them. Not knowing if next year we're going to be wearing masks or not, but if we don't, then it was only $2 each. If we still are wearing masks next year, then we'll be celebrating Mardi Gras in style. All right, y'all. Let's follow along and see what else we can get into. Hello, kitty. Oh, don't trip, Hello Kitty. She's going to go do her meet and greets right now, but we got to meet her first. So we're walking by, and who do we see but Donkey himself. Let's talk to Donkey. Let's see how Donkey's feeling today. Let's see. I'm going to walk through here. All right, see if we can hear him.
All right, buddy. I'll see you.
Hey, Donkey.
What's up, man?
How you doing?
You know.
Chilling?
Just chilling.
All right.
Playing.
Yeah.
What are you up to?
Well, you know, you see my camera, and
I see that.
Yeah, we do a very small little videos for YouTube, but we recorded y'all one day, and that has been our, we got hundreds of thousands.
Because of me?
Because of you.
Awesome,
Donkey,
man.
You are the man. You're awesome. I'm
You're
telling you what.
Man.
Yeah. It was.
You said 20%.
I said what?
You said 20%. Where's the cut, man?
I haven't gotten paid yet.
Come on, man.
I'm needing to get paid.
I'm done. I'm out.
Oh, you know what though? It was what? You were talking to some young little man talking about his dad or somebody worked as a police.
Okay.
It was so funny. I'm telling you what. You got to check us out one day. You know, just Google Donkey on Universal Studios, and. I don't know how your hosts are going to do it, but you'll find a way.
All right.
Yeah.
I'll find it.
Yeah.
I mean, I probably remember. I'll see that. Oh, that was Ferdinand from Mississippi.
Yeah. I'm sure you'll remember.
I remember.
You got a good memory.
I do.
You know what I mean?
Like an elephant.
You're like an elephant, yeah. I mean, I'm just telling you. Your brain is like, you know, you remember a lot of things, like, you know, onions. You know, they got layers.
Man.
They do. All right. Well, you got some folks here that want to see you, I'm sure.
Yeah, they could wait.
Oh, come on. Everybody wants to see Donkey.
Everybody wants to see me.
I do. Go right. See Donkey. I'm in your way. Come on.
See me.
She's coming. She's coming.
5 more minutes.
Oh, he's got to go. It's getting hot outside. You got to get some water. Hot. All right, Donkey. Great seeing you.
I'll see you again.
All right. How cool is it to see Donkey? I love Shrek, all the films. And Donkey was one of the best characters they could have definitely, one of the best characters they could have thought of. He really stole the show, didn't he? And there he is once again, be able to entertain us here at Universal Studios. Here's Hashtag. What's up, Hashtag? How you doing today? All right, Hashtag Fiveless. All right, all right, all right. Busy. I bet it's nice being in there, nice and cool, huh? I mean, it's hot out here. All right, y'all. Hashtag be good. Have fun. So we were told to come here at the Park Plaza Holiday Shop, and we want to look for some duckies. So we're coming to take a look at the duckies. But it's Christmas, folks. You can get all of your Christmas needs just here in this one spot. Hi. She's going to be riding some. Oh, you can get your own skull. That's. Okay, I don't want to bother her. She's making somebody's something for them. We got some Harry Potter. Lots of Harry Potter. Oh, you can even get Harry Potter ribbon. Look at that. You can get the house stripe ribbons. There's a Hufflepuff, you've got Ravenclaw, you've got Gryffindor, Slytherin as well. How cool is that? Oh my gosh, come on now, you know. And then the Yule Ball ribbon. Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to move the camera so quickly. I don't know if you can see that. There you go, let's move. There it is. So cool, is it? So cool. Okay, the nerdism in me is coming out. So the house ribbons are 4 for $45. Not sure if you were able to see this, but if you want the Yule Ball costume ornaments, 6 of them for $100. So this is definitely going to be an expensive tree. I think I'd want to do it in something small, maybe a small tree like this, just to have around the house, you know, in a little corner or knickknack or something, but it's expensive. But once you have it, you got it forever. Look at that. Oh my goodness, how cool is that? Can you see it? Wow, I want to spin this around. Spin it right round, baby, right round, like a record, baby, right round, round, round. Oh, cool. All right. $34 for that globe. Oh, can you see it? Sorry. I think you saw it there. It's not picking it up. All right. Well, not being able to get the best focus. So, and then you can get your name. $17. Let's see if they have Matthew or Matt. Let's take a look. Sandra is not Matthew. That's the S's, A's, H, E, J. They got a Joseph. You see both? Matthew and then Matt? Here it is. So if anybody wants to get me anything, I'll gladly take that. Thank you. How cool. Alrighty. Alright, we came in here to see some stuff, but I'm focusing on the Harry Potter. The house bell ornaments are 4 for $45. Look at these. How cool. If you're a Harry Potter fan like I am, you're definitely going to want to come to the store or definitely want to get some of these ornaments for Christmas. Just think, you can have your own Harry Potter themed Christmas tree. How cool. I'm a Hufflepuff. What are you? They got some Christmas masks down here as well. I sure hope we're not wearing masks by Christmas time, but if you are, like I said earlier, you'll be there in style. Alright, so we came here to look at the ducks. Where are the ducks? There they are. Why am I having an echo? There's an echo right here. There's an echo because of the ceiling. I'm in the center. Oh my gosh, it sounds like a record. I don't want to hear myself. Look at these things. They got little reindeers. I don't want to touch them and ruin it for everybody in case I have germs on my hands, so I'll be thoughtful for this one. Okay. And so these are holiday ducks, 15 for 6. Hey Joe, speak, talk right here. Say something. Get underneath this and say something.
Merry Christmas.
Did you hear the echo?
Yeah.
Let me see if I pick it up in this.
Say, it sounds like a tube echo.
It does, it's so weird. Do you do that all the time?
No, I don't like it.
You don't like it? It's
weird.
Oh, it's weird.
Luke.
So, but it's like a microphone. Yeah, Crystal's, oh my gosh, I gotta get out of it. It's so weird. So Crystal, she does a painting here as well, and it looks like she was painting on something when we walked in. But you can also get your specialized ornament with whatever you want it to read on here, I'm guessing. So it looks like you're doing a skull, and are you doing that for yourself?
For Halloween Horror Nights.
Halloween Horror Nights. Here around the park?
It'll be in the tribute store.
To sell?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, we're getting a special look. Oh my, I don't think that was supposed to happen, but we're doing it anyway. We're not, that's so cool. So you actually get the, folks, thank you. Look there, it's actually hand painted. It's not just something you buy. Somebody actually did the hard work for you. How cool is that? Awesome. All right, I gotta step out of here. This place is mind boggling. Bye-bye, thank you. We're walking through Universal Studios. Joe and I are just talking, trying to figure out what we want to do as we're headed to Diagon Alley. And he goes, oh, look, the shark is back. Shark is back. So, gotta come see the shark, see the improvements that they've made on him. What's his name? Bruce? Anyway, and then of course, Chez Alcatraz is here, ready for your money. And your drinks will be available for you, ready for you. Look at that. I see he's got his teeth back. Let's look. Oh, he's got some new markings on him, doesn't he? I don't know, were these always here? Or are they new? But I do know that these teeth have been done before again. Always, we got a fresh paint job. That tooth was missing before. Look at this. You know, I think what else is missing, there was a bar people could hang on. That's gone. Look how cool this is. This one is already chipped off, but unless it was meant to be that way. This one's missing too. These are rubber pieces, in case you wanted to know. And he's gorgeous. He looks good. Jaws. That's his name. It's not Bruce. Bruce is just so cute. We got King's Cross right here. You can take the train into Islands of Adventure by using Hogwarts. It's an 80-minute wait time, folks. It's worth it. If this is your first time ever doing it, please do yourself a favor and take that train. It is, if you're a Harry Potter fan, I should say, it is so worth it. 80 minutes, sure. Yeah, it's a long time. Is it worth it? 100%. You gotta do it. So I recommend it. That's my two cents. Cheers to you. You can pick up the telephone and listen. We're not doing that today. You got the Underground. Remember that in London, if anybody's been. Somebody's on the phone. She's making her dial. She's making a phone call. Awesome. I love it. I love it. So the Underground station. So this is basically what the subway in London looks like. I like it. I miss it. I haven't been in London in a year and change. So the night bus. We're going to get a little closer to it before we go. Actually, I think we're just going to go through. We're going to go through. Take a look. Have you done Diagon Alley? I'm going to tell you. Look, watch this. There it is. Bam. You're inside. Magical world of Harry Potter. Is it time for it? Are we going to catch it? What time is it, Joe? 3:02. Okay, we may have missed the breathing dragon. Fire. We may have just missed that. Not sure. Yeah, I think we missed it. So if you're hungry, you can always come into the Leaky Cauldron. That's where they serve fish and chips, banger sandwich. Now, I like their fish and chips. I've had that. Bangers and mash. Okay. But even the children's menu. So if you're not that hungry, you can still order from the children's menu. Take a look at it at the Leaky Cauldron. You want to walk in just a tad? Nope, we can't. It doesn't show us. That's just the waiting line. The new wands are being purchased there. But this is where the Ollivanders, you get to select your wand for you. You get to select it for you, I should say. Pretty cool. Oh, it's so hot right here. It's burning up. All right, so over here, you got some. Here, Joe. Come over here. You know, I've never sat on these stairs. Okay. I still don't like it. It really looks like a real snake to me. I don't like it. I know it's fake. I know it's fake, but I hate snakes. Anyway, it's so realistic looking. We are inside of Harry Potter's Diagon Alley, and the dragon's making some noise, so we're trying to catch it. I know you can't see me and this at the same time because of the shadows. I'm sorry, but we're hearing the noises. We just don't know if it's going to work. This is the line. My goodness. The Marble Hall. It's busy in here. Yeah, I've never been in here. What is this?
Pictures.
This is photos. Okay, you can get your photos. Pick them up here. Hi. How y'all doing? Good. Now, I should have noticed this is for photos with the photography equipment in the window. So, there it is. And you can come this way. And then you can purchase your robes. I need me a Hufflepuff robe. I know. But I still want it anyway. All this awesome stuff. Oh, look, 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 look. You know, embroidery is available. When I saw this tie, I noticed there's something embroidered here. I don't remember ever seeing that before. But they've got it. Oh, look, look, look. You can even get your name put on there. How cool is that? I think I need to put Giuseppe on mine. Oh, I just never buy my own stuff. Hi, Joe. What do you think about this place? I'm a Harry Potter fan. Are you? Look at this. You can get your name on this as well. This is the embroidery machine. And we've got bag down here. How cool. I don't remember them having this before, but I wasn't looking. Okay. Winter. I mean, it's just now becoming summer. Winter. I have to have this. I mean, there's no buts. I have to. Remember that. I have to. Oh. Look how pretty they've made this. Look at this dress. Oh, that's so cool how they do things. You can get your watch. I mean, I'm an Apple guy, so I got my Apple Watch, but you can purchase watches here. You can purchase for $100. I don't know what that is. I have no clue what that is. What is that? I can't see it. My angle doesn't show me what it is. So, lots of different things you can get. Hogwarts, other jewelries for the women. Or men, whoever wants to wear it. Hogwarts alumni, yep. I think it's so cool that it's, yes, it was the books. Yes, it was a movie, but it lives on. School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. Love it, I love it, I love it. Okay, I do want to purchase one thing. Where is it? I want a bag, but I don't want a bag that big. I want a bag like he's wearing. One of the small little plastic type, not plastic, whatever they're called. Anyway, that's what I'm looking for. Cool. We got people with questions. I hear the rumbling.
Face covering up over your mouth and nose, my friends.
And his voice is amplified. I got a question. Hi, Jim. How are you?
I am fabulous.
Good. That's Jim, everybody. So, how often does the dragon like to talk to us?
Well, our dragon gets angry from time to time. And when he gets angry, he spews fire.
Yes.
But just like the rest of us, you never quite know what's going to set him off.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
So, is it half the time he likes it? Quarter of the time? He gets upset? Well, we waited and we waited to get the dragon to breathe the fire. It didn't happen. So, we gotta go. We got things to do. And sorry we weren't able to show you this time. We'll see if we can come back another day to do it. Got a couple vloggers here. Uh-oh. They're getting ready. Let's see. Do we know them?
Thank you for tuning into the Wizarding Wireless Network. And now, a live performance direct from Diagon Alley, featuring that musical marvel, that delectable diva, the spectacular singing sorceress herself, Celestina Moore!
Come and take a sip of this sweet tasty drink. Hold her.
Celestina Warbeck.
My dress is fabulous. Profit leaders know, St. Mungo's Hospital for Medical Maladies and Injuries asked me to put my Celestina style to a world-famous Quidditch anthem for charity. Quidditch anthem, Celestina style.
Help so much fun. You just have to see this. I don't want to record the whole thing, but it's pretty awesome. So. Have you seen it? Have you seen them live? It's nice when they don't have the masks. I'm noticing today they're wearing masks. Last time I was here, I don't know if they were wearing the mask, so I may have to check that, but let's see. All right, folks, our day is done. We're getting hungry. We're all going to go to dinner tonight, so if you like this video and others like it, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Also, make sure you hit that bell for future notifications. We sure do enjoy doing these videos, and we want to make sure that you follow along, so please tell your friends about us. We thank you very much. We'll see you soon. Bye.